Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode. So what is our topic today? Today we will take a look at our first three accusative prepositions. And the three ones that we will take a look at today are durch, und für. Yeah, I hope you already understand the case system. You know, it's always a topic. How this actually works in German. So there are two options why we use cases, this nominative, accusative, and also dative. The first one is the verb. Yeah, for example, the verb helfen goes with dative, the verb to be goes with nominative, the verb to see goes with accusative. The second option are prepositions. Yeah? So here we have our first three prepositions that require that the object that follows them, because that's what prepositions do, they are always not followed, but after a preposition always comes an object, and the object has to be an accusative. Yeah, this can either be the an article, like these ones here. It can also be a possessive article, like my or your, and it can be a personal pronoun, but it has to be an accusative. Yeah. So let's have a quick look what these three prepositions mean. We have durch, und für. Durch is the English equivalent for through. For example, I go through the park, or I go through the door. Yeah, and it's actually more or less, I think, maybe like 100% like in German, even though you always have to be careful with prepositions. Yeah. There's one preposition in English that always confused me. It's like I'm on the bus. For me as a German, I'm on the bus sounds like you are on top of the bus. But in English, it actually means that you are in the bus. So prepositions in every language are a bit specific, yeah? Or a bit unique. Yeah? So you have to take care and learn them in context. So, but through is actually pretty much the same as in English. For example, geht durch Park. Yeah, now, of course, you have to know what is the gender of Park. Yeah, what is the grammatical gender? Is it der, die, or das? If you don't know this one, you cannot find the right one in accusative either. This is what makes this case system so tough. You have to know that durch goes with accusative, and you have to know the article of the noun that is following. So now we have it here, yeah, it's der Park. So we have a look, it's der nominative and it's den in dative. So geht durch den Park. Yeah, and durch makes this one accusative. So he goes through the park. The next one is ich reise durch Europa. And as you can see here, Europa, just like all the other continents and all almost all countries and cities, like all cities, but not all countries. There are a couple of exceptions. For example, Switzerland has an article, USA has an article, die Schweiz, die USA, der Irak, der Iran, der Kongo, die Türkei. So there are some countries that have an article, but most countries don't. So if we don't have an article, or Europa doesn't have an article, of course, here in accusative, we also don't have an article. I just gave you this as an example so that you have another sentence with the preposition durch. Yeah, ich reise durch Europa obviously means I travel through Europe. Yeah? Good, dann haben wir die zweite Präposition, das ist And means around. Yeah? For example, I go around the table. Or here also with dates, I will see you around the 12th of October. Yeah, so kind of meaning more or less, yeah, approximately. Also wir fahren Haus. Yeah? Haus is das, so we have a look. Das in accusative is also das, so that's easy. Yeah. So, wir fahren das Haus, which means we drive, yeah? Wir fahren das Haus, around the house. Or, as I just said, I think you can say it in English like this, I'm not 100% sure. Something like, Ich komme um 12.10.2019. If you don't know how to speak these dates, have a look at the video. I think it was number 8, where I explained to you guys how we speak dates in German. So this is der 12.10.2019. Also ich komme um, and dates are always der. So again, der Akkusativ den. Ne? Ja, ich komme um den 12.10.2019, which means I come around the 12th of October 2019. Ne? Like approximately, a couple of days more, a couple of days less. Yeah? I also gave you this example because it's, I think, useful to know that we use in this case as well. For this one, you can, of course, like everything that you can go around. Yeah? You can drive around the house, you can go around the tree, you can go around the table, so it's always the same. Yeah? And then the last one, which is probably the most common accusative preposition, it's für, which means for. Dann haben wir hier einen Satz. Das Geschenk ist für, ja, the gift is for. And I would like to say now, my brother. Wir wissen, dass Bruder der ist. Also haben wir hier einen. And if you want to say my, yeah, you just say meinen. Yeah? Meinen, deinen, seinen. Yeah, you should know the possessive pronouns by now. I hope you do. Huh? So the ending is the same. Yeah? So das Geschenk ist für my. Nen Bruder, ja? The gift is for my brother. Oder das Geschenk ist für, and here we can use one of the personal pronouns, ja? Das Geschenk ist für dich, ja? Das Geschenk ist für sie, das Geschenk ist für ihn, das Geschenk ist für euch, ja? We have to use the personal pronoun in Akkusativ. Here I wanted you to use du, so we have a look. Du in Akkusativ ist dich, ja? Das Geschenk ist für dich, means the gift is for you. Yeah, so that's it for today already. Yeah, so it's a short video. I think not too hard to understand, I hope. If you have any questions, put them in the comment section. As always, you can also write some example sentences and I will have a look and correct them for you guys. Yeah, das war es für heute. Ja, vielen Dank und bis zum nächsten Mal. Tschüss.